Hello there, my name is Emin. I'm representing the company EMCsoft, and this video is part two for my previous video for SPA. And in last video, I didn't show you how I created a business process. And also, I want to show you how you can accept a new candidates from your website. So what happened next is that, for example, you created a job application, and inside of job application you got average score, which calculated automatically. So when you go to review, when you create a new review, so your technical specialist HR create a new review, click 5. Okay, so it's stored. And then if you go back, update your page, you can see that average score increased. So how that happened? Inside of review, when you create review, some automation rules start working. So when new review created, that automation rules start running. And what happened is that in that business process, you link another object, which is a job application. And so you go to log here, then you set the variables. You set variables here as a score sum and review quantity. So to calculate the average one. Then in set variables, which is located right here, you right here these numbers. So you extracting from a job application that number, current number, plus a new one, the same story here, review quantity plus one. Then when you save it here, you sending that back to via webhook to job application. So via this link, which is with my portal, is security link, entity type 168. This entity type you can find here. If you go to smart process, and you see the job application got some entity type 168, the same is here. Then we got ID and a field where we should to write that data, 015, if you go to here. So 015, so it says score sum save there, and the same story, score sum, and the same story 054, this one. So it store that data there. So once it's stored, another business process running, which is in job, inside of job application. So that process starting when data updated. It's just calculate, it just take a field and do a calculation using new numbers. So that's it. And so what next? How you can use that data then? And how candidates can apply for your open positions? So in business model which we done for the client, we used that story. Business story. So we created a website. So we can use any template for now. For example, business create. So open site. So we got website. So we can check that website via that link. So we got that link, but we can change that link. If we go back, click here, and we can put a name, for example, EMCsoft. Okay. Right. Then, so we can publish, or for now, we just need to edit it. So we can delete some information which we don't need in our client. We just publish here a position of a description of that position. So that means that when that candidate will apply for that job, he it will come as a default value. So I will delete just some unnecessary fields, and we can go coming to that particular CRM form which I created before. So what is that form is about? If we go to the CRM forms, so I created a special form which is one form, means one job description. Means that, for example, if somebody see the description of a Java developer, in that particular form he can apply only for Java developer. So when we edit it, we created a field where he need to fill. So in that form we got default values, right? And that default value is a position type job application Java developer, right? And also I created the fields. I will do that from scratch, right? Okay, I delete that. Okay, so I got empty form. First of all, I need to connect that form for particular entities, which is smart process automation, right? Then I need to create a field which should come to that form. So I create the fields in job application, candidate name and candidate surname and date of birth of a candidate, which is very important. And then I will create a default value as job application as a position type. So if somebody going to apply for that job, he will apply from that form, he will apply only for Java developer. He has no option. So I saved, and so I got that form. So I see that form here in my website. And what happened next? I can check that website using that link, and I can apply. So date of birth, candidate name, candidate surname is identification identification of the candidates. So when I use that data, for example, I will put that date of birth. For example, I'll put Amin. No, I need to put some existing one. For example, Emmanuel Kant, send. And what happened is that I got a new job application which come to our CRM system from our website. And the name of a form is particularly said that to which a CRM form candidate applies. Inside of the form, I see that data automatically selected by business process. That data comes directly from that form, name, surname, position type, and date of birth. And using the identification date of birth, name, and surname, a business process find position and candidate. So to not let, for example, one candidate apply by different names. So this is important. to find proper candidates based on his birthday, name and surname, and the same for positions. So we need to have a limited number of positions where candidates may apply. But for that particular business process, we assume that we already got all data for that particular candidate. If we have no data for a particular candidate, we have another business process, probably which I will tell on another video. So we got that position, candidates, and we create in the review and put in a score. And we create in another review. And when we refresh that page, we got average scores for that particular job applications. We created websites for each position, and we assume that we already got a database for each candidate. That's why we our business process, which is running by automation rule. So we got automation rule, which it is run that find candidate in position when a new job application comes. So with new job application coming, it starts searching for new candidates, for the existing candidates and position. That's it, actually. I think that video is extension of my previous video, how you can implement current structure of candidates, positions, job application review. So how you can add this job application as in your website, in your forms, and then new candidate comes, a new job application comes from your website, you can add reviews and do an automatic calculation for average scores. So if you like that video, click like. If you have questions regarding that video, ask your questions in the comments under that video. If you are too lazy to create that structure using SPA, we got application special dedicated for the recruiting app, but it's of course it's more advanced than this one, and we happy to sell it to you. So thank you and bye-bye.